While Lancelot is famous for his deeds in Camelot, serving under King Arthur, he is actually native to France. There, he's raised by his parents, the French King Ban of Benwick, and his wife, Elaine, until they meet an untimely death from an invasion of their home. Lancelot is left behind as an orphaned child. Witnessing his solitude, Nimue, known as the Fairy of the Lake, takes the child in and raises him as her own. Under her care, he becomes known as the Knight of the Lake, growing up with much acclaim, seen as the greatest swordsman and jouster of the age. At one point, he beds with a woman, Elaine of Corbenic, and she gives birth to his son, Galahad. Despite his own deeds as a fine knight, he comes upon rumors surrounding the famed King of Britain, Artoria Pendragon. These rumors seem to overshadow his own fame, and he reacts by belittling them. For a time, he compares himself to the King of Knights, downplaying the king's acclaim to embellish his own. Eventually, however, he yearns to discover the truth behind the rumors and sets out to witness the king for himself. Upon arriving in Britain, he immediately gets his chance by coming across a battle against invaders. Through his own eyes, Lancelot witnesses what appears to be a young boy on horseback, bravely charging through hordes of invaders. He discovers in this moment that he was wrong about Britain's king entirely. Through the king's swordsmanship, he can see unwavering conviction. Acknowledging the king's strength, Lancelot joins the battle himself and helps quell the invasion. As recompense, he is invited to Camelot as Artoria's honored guest. There, Lancelot's fascination with the King of Knights swells, envying the Knights of the Round Table, quickly coveting his own seat among them. Thankfully, as a man of his caliber, he joins the Round Table with ease. Now a member of his new king's most prestigious knighthood, Lancelot assists in many battles against Britain's invaders. Beyond this, he is involved with a number of famous exploits. One such achievement occurs when Lancelot falls for an enemy's trap, betrayed by a maiden. He finds himself unarmed against his enemy, a warrior named Sir Phelot, and is able to skillfully emerge victorious with nothing but his ability to fight with a mere elm branch. Over time, Lancelot earns his place as Artoria's greatest companion, the king's most trusted knight. As part of the king's reign, Artoria marries Lady Guinevere to provide Britain with both king and queen. Despite the king's service, the people begin to criticize Artoria. Sir Tristan, in particular, leaves Camelot after declaring, "The king does not understand how others feel." With this, Artoria's stable nation begins to shake, and tension builds among the knights. These words affect Lancelot deeply, and he begins to seek a way to ease his king's burden. In this effort, he converses with Guinevere, who also hopes to assist Artoria. As they consult one another, Lancelot learns that his beloved king is in fact a woman, marrying Guinevere to preserve political stability. He finds that Guinevere is sacrificing her ability to live as a normal woman in order to preserve Artoria's kingdom. This is not to say Artoria and Guinevere do not care for one another. Rather, it is the discovery that there is no romance between them. With this knowledge, Lancelot finds himself greatly attracted to Guinevere. The two fall in love, and they consider fleeing Camelot together, but both are compelled by their duty and loyalty to Artoria, and instead remain while hiding their affair. Whatever joy they find from their secret courtship is accompanied by tremendous guilt. Guinevere, especially, for her admiration and support of Artoria, is stained with tears from her infidelity. Lancelot watches Guinevere in her slumber, certain that even in dream, she is apologizing. Lancelot, as a Knight of the Round, is an object of desire for many women, many of whom try to charm him. Of course, he is serious about his commitment to Guinevere, using this as resolve to turn them down. This even helps him resist when Artoria's scheming sister, Morgan le Fay, attempts to entrance him. While still at a young age, Lancelot's son, Galahad, becomes the youngest of Artoria's knights, earning a reputation for his purity. Despite their blood relation, now that Galahad is no longer a boy, he no longer views Lancelot like a father, and their relationship is tense. Artoria embarks on her campaign to Rome, entrusting Britain's care to her knights. Among them, Sir Agravain devotes himself to Artoria, despite being employed by Morgan le Fay to sabotage Artoria's reign. Still technically a spy, Agravain remains in contact with informants, enemies to the throne. From them, he learns of Lancelot's affair with Guinevere and decides to expose them publicly as traitors. During the encounter, Lancelot becomes enraged from hearing Agravain mock Guinevere for her infidelity and takes up his blade, striking Agravain down. In the wake of his fury, Lancelot flees the country, returning to France, slaying many of his former allies during his escape. Lady Guinevere is imprisoned for her treachery. Despite this, she is guarded by her sympathizers, Gareth and Gaheris. Unable to live without his beloved, Lancelot returns to rescue Guinevere, charging the prison and murdering his comrades. He kills all the guards and escapes once more, this time with his love in tow. Soon enough, Artoria hears news of the affair and sends a letter to Lancelot, forgiving him for his actions. "My friend, my pride, my ideal knight, if you had seen it fit to commit such actions, they must have had a good cause." Lancelot is paralyzed, unable to fathom being forgiven for such crimes. To sate his guilt, he seeks contempt and punishment, not forgiveness. This emphasizes for him just how monstrous Artoria is. An inhuman king with no selfish desires of her own. The fallout from this betrayal is tremendous. For someone like Lancelot, who was a symbol of perfection to both knights and all living men in the kingdom, to suddenly be exposed as an adulterous traitor is absolutely devastating. The stability of the knights crumbles, sowing the seeds of rebellion. Due to Lancelot's actions, Britain is divided and vulnerable when Artoria's child, Mordred, takes the throne and begins civil war with Artoria during the bloody Battle of Camlann. Lancelot wishes to return and join Artoria in the battle, but is adamantly denied by Sir Gawain, who refuses to forgive Lancelot for slaughtering his siblings. Ultimately, Artoria loses the fight, being struck a fatal blow. Her kingdom meets its end. Upon learning of Artoria's death, Lancelot finds his guilt and despair overwhelming and succumbs to madness, a trait that follows him to his own death. His sullied reputation becomes recorded into the Throne of Heroes as an anti-hero. In the modern era, leading up to the Fourth Holy Grail War, Tokiomi Tosaka, following mage tradition, gives up his daughter Sakura to be raised by the Mato family so that he can devote himself to raising Rin as a successor. An outcast from the Mato household, Karia Mato is deeply in love with Tokiomi's wife, Aoi, and is shocked to hear of Sakura's adoption. In Aoi's honor, Karia returns to the Mato family in order to protect Sakura from the Mato family head, Zoken. His fears are confirmed when he discovers Sakura being violated by a hive of disgusting crestworms. To save her, Karia appeals to Zoken, begging to take her place in the worm pit, vowing to claim the Grail by himself to set her free. In a twisted deal with Zoken, Karia undergoes his own worm treatment, cultivating his weak magic circuits to handle the role of being a master. While this works, the procedure nearly kills him and continues to draw at his life. To compensate for Karia's fragility, Zoken has him add a mad enhancement to the summoning ritual to ensure he calls upon a berserker-class servant. Thus, for the Fourth Holy Grail War, Karia summons Lancelot as his ultimate weapon. Clad in dark armor from head to toe, Lancelot's identity is thoroughly hidden, both visually and behaviorally. The distinctive features of his armor are clouded by his noble phantasm for someone's glory, mimicking the undercover operations he embarked on as a knight. While under the effects of mad enhancement, he is strengthened greatly at the expense of his ability to think and speak rationally. In battle, Lancelot is highly powerful, but exceptionally difficult to control. The mana required to bring out Lancelot's full potential puts so much strain on Karia that the crestworms inside him writhe and cause him intense pain. Despite Lancelot's low magic resistance, his skill, Protection of the Fairies, increases his luck in harsh situations. For his achievement fighting off Felit with nothing but a branch, Lancelot has an ability called Knight of Honor. A knight does not die with empty hands, that allows him to apply his techniques with other enemy weapons or even different inanimate objects. This ability even allows him to wield swords launched from Gilgamesh's Gate of Babylon. These objects, in his hands, are empowered enough to clash with noble phantasms. Throughout the war, Kharia has Lancelot target Gilgamesh, the servant of his rival Tokiomi. Yet, Lancelot is unable to restrain himself whenever part of an encounter against Artoria. His rage and attention are easily drawn to his inhuman king. Tokiomi is eventually murdered by his apprentice, Kirei Kotomine, and his body is staged to frame Kharia for the crime. Aoi finds her husband's corpse and blames his death on Kharia, fearing her hatred. Kharia sinks into his own madness, strangling her nearly to death. His love now clearly out of reach, Kharia pushes forth blindly while continuing the war. In a parking garage, beneath the Lesser Grail's enshrinement, Lancelot blocks Artoria's path, finally drawing his own true noble phantasm, Erendite, the unfading light of the lake, Excalibur's sister sword, and another divine construct gifted by fairies. With his sword drawn, Lancelot's For Someone's Glory and Knights of Honor abilities are sealed, finally revealing his identity to Artoria. The one she had trusted, the one she had fought alongside, has become a violent maniac with razor-sharp teeth and an undying resentment toward her. Lancelot dominates their fight with his devastating attacks, paired with Artoria's hesitation, until, ultimately, she finds an opening to take him down. Lancelot's mana exertion puts too much strain on Kharia. At this time, Lancelot is vulnerable, unable to proceed, giving Artoria her chance to strike. No longer empowered by mad enhancement, he is run through by Excalibur. A defeated servant, he fades away, explaining that his madness came from an unrequited yearning to incur Artoria's wrath. He desired punishment, only to be met with naive forgiveness. This goes down as a definitive symbol of Artoria's failure to understand her people, a driving force to break her spirit.
This video is brought to you in part by HelloTalk, an amazing app for learning languages through social exchange. If you've ever wanted to learn a language, perhaps Japanese, then HelloTalk may be perfect for you. As a supplement to hitting the books or taking classes, the HelloTalk app provides you efficient tools to learn by speaking directly with fluent speakers of your target language. It's a mutual exchange between yourself and partners, teaching each other through text, voice, and even video communication. It comes filled with translation tools to help the process along, offering a unique experience that formal education can't match. A ton of practical knowledge I have about Japan came from interacting with a pen pal I made online, which turned into a solid friendship of cultural exchange. With HelloTalk, getting that genuine experience is easier than ever. It's totally free for the first language, and you can get it for both iOS and Android devices. To get started, simply click the link in the top right or the link in the description below.
Thank you for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, then go check out some of my other lore videos. It's my goal to make one of these for virtually every servant in the Nasuverse, and I would appreciate your support through that journey. The best way would be to become a patron of the channel. We offer different reward tiers, ranging from early access to the chance to suggest your very own video. Oh, and don't forget to subscribe to Otaku Daikun for more anime lists, reviews, discussions, lore videos, let's plays, and the holy waifu wars. Until next time, celebrate your fandom.